the Young Turks 14 years.
Hello and welcome to this Young Turks exclusive. I'm Shireen Bhan and I'm in conversation with a man who founded Myntra, then sold it to Flipkart 2 years ago and has now decided to start his third innings. Mukesh Bansal, thanks very much for joining us on CNBC TV 18. Let me start by asking you, on the face of it, it seems like it was a friendly parting. There was no acrimony there, but what's the inside story? You know, there's been a lot of rumors during the rounds that it was on account of the elevation or the restructuring that we saw at Flipkart. Is that the real reason why you decided to move on?
Actually, you know, it is all quite amicable. You know, I had enjoyed my 2 years at Flipkart. I think it was great working with Sachin, Bini and the team. We started talking about, you know, how to run Flipkart going forward, and after we decided to restructure, and with Bini coming as a CEO, I, you know, evaluated my role and realized that all the work I did last year to build a team at Flipkart, you know, we had a great leadership in place, a great CEO in Myntra and Anant. So I felt it was a good logical point for me with the, you know, team already in place, good momentum, a new CEO coming in, and I sense a window of opportunity for me to possibly move on.
Was it becoming top heavy in that sense, and you felt that you wouldn't have that much meaningful stuff to really do?
I think I wouldn't look at it that way. I think there is, you know, in some ways what we are trying to do is very challenging. I think it's a lot of problems yet to be solved. But I felt, you know, there is a, this is time where if I would step aside, there are enough people in the team who can step up and fill in the, you know, role that I was playing. So sensing that opportunity where I can step back and still feel comfortable that both Myntra and Flipkart are very good hands with, you know, very promising future ahead of us. And personally, we'll take some time off and figure out what I'm doing next. I think it's just good timing.
What did the investors have to say when you decided that, to tell them that you've decided to move on?
I think different reaction.
And were they in the loop when
investor
you made
up your mind? Especially the guys I work closely with, you know, I consulted with them, discussed with them. Usually, you know, a lot of founders move on after acquisition. The fact that around 2 years.
Yeah, you stayed around for 2 years.
So some were surprised I stayed that long. Some were surprised that, you know, I'm moving on now.
So the reason I ask you about the timing and I guess the rumors, you know, during the rounds is because of the restructuring that we saw. It's not just you, but it was also Ankit Nagori, the chief business officer at Flipkart, who decided to move on. The two of you, I understand, are very close. So does this have to do with the fact that Sachin and Bini decided to rejig their roles and portfolios?
I think there's a lot of attention being paid to, you know, two people moving on. Last year, in senior leadership alone, we hired, you know, more than 10 people. And extended leadership team, close to 25 people. So when you're 25 people joining the team, someone senior like 3, 4, 5 moving on is quite normal. It's also a deliberate, you know, with Bini coming as CEO, me feeling that he can start from blank slate. There's a new team that he can work with. So instead of, you know, let's say if once I made up my mind to move on, I felt this is, you know, better timing because he's just settling into a new role versus, you know, let's say moving on 6 months or 1 year down the line.
So now, in a sense, you're emotionally and physically detaching yourself from your babies. You know, how hard was this decision for you?
It was quite difficult. I think at least for a couple of weeks, and after I mentally decided I want to move on, I think it was emotionally quite difficult. But simultaneously, also feeling very free and liberated. You know, it's been very, very stressful. So being able to renew myself, look at a number of new things and start from fresh, and also
You're sounding like Vishal Sikka now. New and renew is what you're going to be focusing on. But, you know, I'll talk to you on the new opportunities that you're exploring in just a second. But let me ask you about what you've left behind. And the last conversation that we had, that you were fairly confident of being able to move to the path of profitability. But are you on track? Because if I were to look at the FY15 numbers, estimates suggest a reported loss of 740 crores and a revenue of 758 crores. So losses have been piling on. Are you on track to be able to get to the road to profitability?
I think in Myntra, we have covered huge ground in terms of profitability. You know, we are the only large-scale e-commerce company in India which is unit e-commerce profitable. You know, it happened in October. Since then, we are staying on and the, you know, what we call GP0. So good progress on that front. Our own brands are starting to achieve some scale, Roadster, All About You, HRX, etc., which are contributing to positive gross margin.
So how much would the private brands make up as far as total revenues are concerned?
So I'm very confident. I think Myntra will be the first profitable company in all of e-commerce in India. It may still take another 12 to 18 months, but it's not that far off. And we've seen, you know, everything from EBIT percentages to GP0, to most of the ratios, you know, steadily improving.
So far, it's been a revenue game.
Right.
But you believe that the bottom line story is going to look different in 2017?
No, absolutely.
Not just for Myntra, but for the industry?
I think, you know, so Myntra may be first one to get there, but overall industry, some of the, you know, smaller niche players will also start to see profitability in 2017-18. We have achieved the scale, and it's an imperative that there is a very credible path to profitability.
People question this credible path to profitability that you're talking about. I mean, people question the valuations, but people also question this elusive profitability. Sure. Yeah. I mean, you when we last spoke, said that you were expecting to be profitable in FY17. You're saying that it could be another 12 to 18 months before that happens for Myntra. Mm-hmm. But even if I were to look at the Flipkart story, I mean, the losses continue to mount even as far as Flipkart is concerned. Mm-hmm. So which is why people then don't believe this credible road to profitability theory.
Almost all the metrics I look at, you know, especially compare year over year, they're all improving steadily, right? So our burn as a percentage of revenue is steadily going down. Mm-hmm. So that's a good sign of progress. Our gross profit percentage per order is improving. Marketing GN as a percent of revenue steadily improving. So for me, all those are good signs. I feel very confident that for Flipkart also the profitability is not that far out. It may still take few years, but it's and
there's a choice. 3 years, 5 years, 7 years.
I will give 2 to 3 years.
2 to 3 years.
Yeah, and more importantly, I think if the market was not growing as fast as it is, right? If we choose today, we could be significantly, you know, more profitable relatively, you know, this year. But then we have to give up on growth, and I think still very early stage.
So you're saying the strategic choice will continue to be to drive growth, even at the cost of profitability, at least for now?
Maybe let's say 2 years ago, 100% focus was on growth and not on profitability. I would say last 12 to 18 months has become at least half-half.
So 50-50.
Forward, yeah, and going forward is probably a little more on profitability, a little less on growth.
Is this investor-driven?
Yeah.
Are they running out of patience?
No, absolutely not. I think, you know, that's, I hear this question a lot, investor-driven. It's a, I think there's a, all companies have a board, you know, board have fiduciary responsibility to give right strategic advice. But all good-run companies, the most of the decisions are left to the management team.
But is that really true? Because, you know, a lot of these companies have common investors. Yeah. One also hears about how strategic choices are made because investors believe, you know, if we need to lose money, let's lose money on one entity as opposed to several entities. So perhaps a lot of the consolidation is also going to be investor-driven. You don't believe that to be true.
I can't, you know, talk about other companies, but I know, like, speaking of Myntra and Flipkart experience, you know, the amount of autonomy and decision-making in management is phenomenal. Plus, if you look at the kind of, you know, management teams you've built, highly, you know, accomplished people, like, the only way to get the best out of them is to empower and delegate, you know, with Excel, Tiger, you know, Kalari. Like, these are, I had a phenomenal experience and never felt that there's any critical decision that was driven by investors or the board.
Are you done with e-commerce and fashion, or is that likely to be something that you would want to go back to?
I think I've done my bit in terms of operating e-commerce business.
The Young Turks 14 years